Hi, I'm Ash with From Bedroom to Banger, and welcome back to my channel. Today, I will be making... G-House?
What
the heck is G-House? To be honest, I just recently heard this term, and it's because I don't really pay attention to genres, but I've also heard this style referred to as bass house or deep house, even electro, but I'm talking about artists like Habstrack, Joyride, a little bit of Skrillex that fuses elements from hip hop, house. It comes in like tons of different flavors. Sometimes it's super heavy. Can be super minimal, or it can just be wacky. It's groovy, it's dark, it's a little chaotic, and if you know me, I feed off chaos. In fact, I got really inspired to make G-House because I did have one of the most chaotic weekends, but we'll get into that in a second. To start, we're gonna need three things. We're gonna need a rap, hip-hop vocal, something catchy, a house beat, and then we're gonna need to make a bunch of dark, chaotic synths. So let's start with the vocal. I found this pack full of acapellas. I'm pretty sure this is free, so I'm gonna toss this into the Discord. So if you're not in the Discord, join below. Link will be blah, 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 whatever. But I found this one. Dreams gotta follow mine. Swimming in the money, Scrooge McDuck, singing dollar signs. And the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna pitch it up a few semitones, change it to Complex Pro, and don't forget to double time it. Follow mine, swimming in the money, Scrooge McDuck, singing dollar signs. All I know is gotta grind. Add the processing, OTT. Follow mine, swimming in the money, Scrooge McDuck. Reverb, sidechain. Gotta follow mine, swimming in the money, Scrooge McDuck, singing dollar signs. And EQ, just to take out all the lows and boost the highs a little. All I know, singing follow mine, swimming in the money, Scrooge McDuck, singing dollar signs. Drums. So to make house drums, they are pretty straightforward. You want to put a kick, and you want to find something nice and punchy on every beat. We call this four to the floor. Sounds like this. Next, we add a clap on every other beat. And for the clap, I'm just gonna do a bit of processing on it, a bit of saturator to boost some distortion, and then we take out all of the mids and lows and give it a nice boost on the high. So it's tight, gotta have it tight. Next, the open hi-hat. And you do that in between every beat. So it looks like this. Then, for that true house groove, I added closed hats right before the open hats. Then a neat little trick you can do, take it a little bit off the grid, and you do that for every single sample. And then we have true house drums. Now we just need the bass, or synths, or whatever. The easiest way to start, an 808 sample. That'll make up the basis of your drum. So start with an 808 sample and bring it into a sampler. I use Tuner to find the key of the 808. Drag it in, it'll look like this, and your root key will be set default to C, so go ahead and play that. Look at Tuner and it'll give you the proper note that you need to set it to. So that's C sharp. There you go. Next, I just add some simple distortion to it, give it a bit of grit. So before and after. A little bit of sidechain, and I EQ out all the highs. Easy. Okay, so where's the chaos? We will get there. Now we write the bass line. So this is where the rest of the song will kind of bloom from. This is what I ended up writing. But if you're like me, you have trouble writing a melody, try and focus on the rhythm. So how I did this was I actually had the drums and the vocal playing at the same time. Just stick with one note. For this one, I just picked F, and I would play on my keyboard. It's easiest when you combine long notes with short notes, especially if you have a sidechain on, because that adds to the grooviness. And then the easiest way to turn it into a melody is to just go up on the chromatic scale.
No, not theory!
Chill, chill. It's easy. That just means you go up and down one semitone, which is from here to here. And you can go up and down. that's that. Now that we have our bass melody, we can really flesh this out with additional sounds. So now we need some leads. I'm gonna copy the MIDI over and just take out the first notes. Eventually it looks like this. Then I went and I picked a preset. Woo! Don't hate. And I picked a thick analog FM type sound. This works really well because it's all analog wavetables. Very thick, that dial tone sound. And that's what I was going for. Needed a bit more love, so I added a frequency shifter to add some harmonics. And really dial in on that dial tone sound. Squish it with OTT. And EQ, dialing in on the dial tone. I've only got it pumping through the exact mids, and I'm taking out all the lows and the highs to make room for the bass. For that first hit we removed, I like to add wobbly synth, something like this. Make sure you put that on the first beat, which will be available through this month's treasure coffer on Patreon. So just a bit of OTT and EQ on that, all together. We're riffing! We got riffs! Riffs for days! And finally, just a little plucky type of guy to fill up the highs and complement the main bass. Now it sounds dope, but you can hear it's missing something. That's where the chaos comes in. I was inspired to make this because last weekend I went on a bachelor party trip, and since it's a current world event, we can't really go to a show or anything, so we went like up north to a cottage, and I'm like, yo, we should just spend the day out on a boat on the water. It's gonna be dope. But get out there, it's like 30 kilometers out, and the boat dies, and the four of us are all stranded. No phone service. We literally have to paddle the boat to the nearest shore, and we had a little hike through the forest, got to the main road. Didn't think I'd be hitchhiking at a bachelor party, but you know, this is my life. I ended up in some random man's truck, and the entire time we had G-House playing in the background. I thrive off the chaos, and we have to add that into the song. And I realized, like, what's the G and G-House stand for? It's obviously... it needs to go throughout the entire song. What up, Eliminate?
I recorded some samples over the weekend for another fun production challenge. I got my
goose
to produce some vocals over the microphone.
Bring in the chaos! Follow my Just kidding, Nate, I love you. This is day one of trying to get Eliminate to notice me. If you wanted to take this even further, you can copy in a bunch of elements, put the drums into halftime, and then... But that is all the time I have for today. I want to shout out the sponsor of this video, which is you, the true homies on Patreon. Thank you so much for helping support the channel. The treasure coffer for October will be out as well, so check that. Click the link in Patreon to go grab that. But if you'd rather support for free, if you like what I'm doing, please, please, please like and subscribe this video. It really, really helps me out. Follow me on all my socials. I see your DMs. Join the Discord. Come hang out. But that's gonna be all. Let's check out the final result. This is what we made. Thanks for watching. Bye. See you.